Good morning. Welcome to Holy Family Parish in Pilsen. Please stand and join us in our opening hymn, O God Beyond All Praising, number 614 in the Blue Hymnal, number 614.
In the name of the Father, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, joy, immense joy, fills our hearts today as we offer the holy sacrifice of the Mass on Priesthood Sunday, a very wonderful day to remember the priesthood of Father Emil Capon, whose mortal remains, after many prayers have been answered, have returned to be with us in our midst. And so we thank God for this unique blessing, and we ask God to bless the priesthood of the Church, and in particular the priesthood that men share in the priesthood of Jesus Christ. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace on earth, peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace on earth, peace to people of good will. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer.
You are seated
at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. Glory to God. Glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace on earth, peace to people of good will. You alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace on earth, peace to people of good will. Let us pray. O God, who made your only begotten Son, eternal High Priest, grant that those he has chosen as ministers and stewards of your mysteries may be found faithful in carrying out the ministry they have received. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Numbers. The Lord came down in the cloud and spoke to Moses, taking some of the spirit that was on Moses. The Lord bestowed it on the 70 elders. And as the spirit came to rest on them, they prophesied. Now, two men, one named Elad and the other Medad, were not in the gathering, but had been left in the camp. They too had been on the list, but had not gone out to the tent. Yet the Spirit came to rest on them also. and they prophesied in the camp. So when a young man quickly told Moses, Eldad and Medad are prophesying in the camp, Joshua, son of Nun, who from his youth had been Moses' aide, said, "Moses, my lord, stop them." But Moses answered him, "Are you jealous for my sake? Would that all the people of the Lord were prophets. Would that the Lord might bestow his spirit on them all." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Precepts of the Lord give joy to the heart.
The law of the Lord is perfect, refreshing the soul. The decree of the Lord is trustworthy, giving wisdom to the
The precepts of the Lord give joy to the heart.
The fear of the Lord is pure, enduring forever. The ordinances of the Lord are true, all of them just.
The precepts of the Lord give joy to the heart.
Oh, your servant is careful of them, very diligent in keeping them. Yet who can deflect act vainly?
The precepts of the Lord give joy to the heart.
From molten sin restrain your servant. Let no rule over me. Then I shall be blameless and innocent of serious sin.
The precepts of the Lord give joy to the heart.
A reading from the letter of St. James. Come now, you rich, weep and wail over your impending miseries. Your wealth has rotted away, your clothes have become moth-eaten. Your gold and silver have corroded, and that corrosion will be a testimony against you. It will devour your flesh like a fire. You have stored up treasure for the last days. Behold, the wages you withheld from the workers who harvested your fields are crying aloud, and the cries of the harvesters have reached the ears of the Lord of hosts. You have lived on earth in luxury and pleasure. You have fattened your hearts for the day of slaughter. You have condemned, you have murdered the righteous one. He offers you no resistance. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Be in your mind, on your lips, you might proclaim his gospel.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
At that time, John said to Jesus, "Teacher, we saw someone driving out demons in your name, and we tried to prevent him because he does not follow us." Jesus replied, "Do not prevent him. There is no one who performs a mighty deed in my name who can at the same time speak ill of me. For whoever is not against us is for us. Anyone who gives you a cup of water to drink because you belong to Christ, amen, I say to you, will surely not lose his reward. Whoever causes one of these little ones who believe in me to sin, it would be better for him if a great millstone were put around his neck and he were thrown into the sea. If your hand causes you to sin, cut it off. It is better for you to enter into life maimed than with two hands to go into Gehenna, into the unquenchable fire. And if your foot causes you to sin, cut it off. It is better for you to enter into life crippled than with two feet to be thrown into Gehenna. And if your eye causes you to sin, pluck it out. Better for you to enter into the kingdom of God with one eye than with two eyes to be thrown into Gehenna, where their worm does not die and the fire is not quenched." The Gospel of the Lord.
Good morning, everyone. I am simply delighted to be with you, the members of this parish, today to lead you in prayer, a prayer of thanksgiving for the return of the mortal remains of your beloved son from this parish, the great hero of our diocese, the great priest of our diocese, Father Emil Capon. The events that have led up to this moment and the days that will follow, beginning last March, of learning of Father Capon's identification and his eventual return back to Kansas, I knew would be received nowhere better than right here in Pilsen by the people who, over these many years, family, friends, fellow parishioners, have been praying again and again, countless numbers of prayers for this day. And in God's providence, it has all come to pass. And it is our special joy to be witnesses of this and to be present for this moment of the life of the church here in this parish and in our diocese. So I stand as one expressing my deep gratitude to God for all of this. And I join you in offering this prayer of thanksgiving for this incredible blessing to have Father Capon's mortal remains back with us. I want to thank you for welcoming us today. I want to welcome in a special way Bishop Richard Spencer, an auxiliary of the Military Archdiocese of the Ordinariate of the Military Archdiocese. Bishop Spencer is first learned of Father Capon, he told me, before Mass in the 1970s, when he himself was stationed before his ordination in Korea, and where people were speaking about Father Capon with such great pride and such great gratitude, and that has led him to learn of his witness and his life story, his mission, And so he's here today to express his own personal gratitude to God for all of this. So welcome Bishop Spencer to the Diocese of Wichita and to Pilsen, Kansas. And of course, we're very delighted to have with us Father John Yurok, a native son of these parts, and his family belonged to this parish. And so, Father John, we're welcome you here as also a native son of the parishes here and a priest of our diocese. And Father David Leese, the Vicar General of the diocese, who with me and Father Wayne Schmidt and Mr. Scott Carter went to Honolulu these past days and participated in the transfer of the mortal remains of Father Capon to his family, and then all the events that have led up to his return today. I can't speak for him, but I can certainly say for myself that these last days are days that I will never forget and will reflect upon continually, because I am sure that they will make a profound impact on who I am as a priest and who I am as a bishop, to have given this great privilege and honor to bring Father Capon's remains back here to Kansas, along with his family, of course, and to welcome him back home, where so many, including all of yourselves, are eager to participate in this event. It was our special, very, very special honor and privilege to view his remains with Ray and his wife Lee on the day of the transfer, and to actually see his skeletal remains and to pray with them and to invite the Lord to bless us through them, as we know he will. So those are just incredible blessings that I wanted to share with you and to assure you of the that all of this has been done with the highest amount of respect, and we're here today to just thank God for all of that. We join all of you in expressing our deepest thanks to God for bringing the remains of your native son, Father Emil, back to Kansas and to the parish where he began his earthly life and where he was first introduced to the faith in this church, a faith that he took with him to all parts of his journey. I certainly have no doubt in saying that wherever he went, he probably always thought of this parish and his family, of course, and fellow parishioners and friends. His letters reveal that he took a lot of who he became here in Pilsen and from St. John Nepomucene's parish. He took all that with him. And in his mind, he was perhaps longing for the day when he would return and resume his earthly life here in the midst of the diocese that he loved so much. But that was not God's plan, but God had other plans. But today, part of that plan is that we bring his remains here in this church where he served first as an assistant and then as pastor for a short time. The church where he celebrated his first mass, where he was baptized. All these things come together here in this beautiful church of our diocese that all made a profound impact and influence in who he was and who he became and the service that he offered as a priest, as a military chaplain, as a man of God, a servant of the Lord. There are many facets, you know them as well as I do, of Father Capon's life that deserve our consideration and even our imitation. Like the many sides of a brilliant diamond, the more I read about him, the more I reflect upon his letters to his parents and to Bishop Carroll and to others, the more you see those facets of his life just come into clearer focus. All of them are unique and beautiful. One could rightly recall, especially here, young Father Emil's early years, his relationship with his parents, his dedication to hard work, his simple way of life. Here, young Emil grew into the man God needed him to become, a man of virtue, a man of values, a man who knew and wasn't afraid to roll up his sleeves and work hard and to do sometimes unsavory things, a man of quiet but profound determination, All of these things are wonderful virtues and qualities that hopefully all of us can develop in our own lives with his intercession. But divine providence today has provided us an important part of Father Emil's life that I believe deserves our consideration more than anything, especially today, and that is that he shared in the priesthood of Jesus Christ. Today the church celebrates Priesthood Sunday, a Sunday when the church reflects together on the importance of our priests, not who they are individually, but in their mission, in their ministry. The church, the Catholic Church, would never be what it's supposed to be without the ministry of good, holy, and faithful priests. And I can think of nothing more important for us to consider and that we give thanks to God for today in that Emil Capon shared in the priesthood of Jesus Christ. God put the desire of the priesthood in young Emil's heart at an early age. That thought was no doubt supported and encouraged by his parents, his pastor, and the religious sisters responsible for his formation. It seems, from all that we can gather, that no one was surprised by this desire to become a priest. As he developed and grew into mature manhood, so too did his desire to be a priest, which inspired him then to apply for the seminary and to undertake the many years of study and spiritual development, all which he did humbly, sincerely, and with dedication. And all of this, as we know, culminated in his ordination to the priesthood in 1940, a day that was very important in his life and journey, a day that was important for this parish, and a few weeks later he came here to celebrate his first Holy Mass, celebrating that Mass on our high altar. All of us who are priests, we can attest that on ordination day, we have no way of knowing how God will use us for his divine purpose. We have no idea to where we will be sent and to whom we will be sent in the trajectory of our priestly life and mission. We simply offer our lives in service to the church. Young Father Capon was no different, but like all of us, he laid down his life and surrendered his will to the will of the church as it would be expressed in the office of his bishop. At first, it seemed he would do what most diocesan priests do, serve in the diocese, serve in parish ministry. He began his priestly life here in his home parish. A bit unusual, if one can say so, to go back to your home parish. I'm sure his parents were delighted when Bishop sent him back here. Soon, however, he would hear, deep within his soul, a desire to be a priest for a specific group of Christ's flock, those in the armed forces. From there, of course, we know the rest of his story so very well. But it was his priesthood that was the foundation of his service to the soldiers he supported. He was chaplain, Father Capon, and as a priest, he became a spiritual father to those men in a way that changed their lives. Friends, I would suggest that the manner with which Father Capon shared in the priesthood, which we know so well today because of the men who returned from Korea to tell us of his heroic witness, I would suggest that his witness is critically necessary for our priests in the church today, especially since the priesthood has been so severely attacked by the enemies of the church and so sadly damaged by even some priests and bishops themselves. Yes, we need priests like Father Emil Capon, who are not afraid to roll up their sleeves and work diligently for the needs of the people entrusted to their care. We need priests to live moral and virtuous lives that are clearly evident, to put the needs of the flock of Christ before their very own. The church deserves and needs priests who are selfless, who are dedicated,
and who are Christ-like, as Father Capon was so clearly in his priesthood. One of the emotions I felt so strongly and still do as I was honored to view the remains of this humble and holy priest when we were in Honolulu is that I need to step up my game when it comes to my own living of the priestly life. I need to renew my own priesthood as I live it now in the office of bishop, so that my actions, both seen and unseen, are steeped in the quality of self-giving and self-sacrifice that was so evident in the life and the ministry of Father Capon. I pray the same action of grace will anoint the hearts of all of our priests in this diocese, regardless of the stage of their priesthood, and all priests throughout the church. Finally, I ask that Father Capon will intercede for us to encourage and inspire more and more young men to respond to the call from God to be priests. I am confident with his intercession, we will see more and more men step forward to consider and discern and to prepare for the holy priesthood of Jesus Christ. May they see Father Emil Capon as a worthy model of the priesthood, for in my humble judgment, they can find none better. Servant of God, Father Emil Capon, pray for us. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Father Emil Capon shared in the priesthood of Jesus Christ. Help us always through his intercession to offer our prayers now to God, our Heavenly Father.
For the shepherds of the church, for the Pope, bishops, and priests, that their faith-filled teaching and preaching will lead all God's people into one sheepfold of grace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an end to religious persecution and terrorism, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our parish to be ever more devoted to Jesus in the Holy Eucharist, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That Christian families will be strengthened to face every challenge and difficulty and to grow in holiness, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the poor, the suffering, and the lonely, for all who do not know the love of Jesus, and for those who have died, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the grace to courageously uproot sin in our lives by turning to the Lord, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
This Mass is being offered for all our military men and women who fought and died serving America. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. We pray in thanksgiving for the return of the mortal remains of Father Emil Capon, in thanksgiving for this grace, and that we will be inspired by his life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our
prayer. We pray for all the priests of the church, that they might look to Father Capon as an example of how to live as priest and victim. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our
O God, we thank you today for this opportunity to express our deepest thanks for the many blessings you give us. Help us through the ministry of priests to grow in holiness. This and all things we ask through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Please join us in our offertory song, Prayer of St. Francis, number 738, in the blue hymnal, number 738.
Make me a channel of your peace.
Where there is hatred,
let me bring your love.
Where there is hatred, you're
welcome.
Receive,
and Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O God, who have willed that your priests should minister at the holy altar and serve your people, grant by the power of this sacrifice, we pray, that their labors may constantly please you, and in your church bear that fruit which lasts forever. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For by the anointing of the Holy Spirit, you made your only begotten Son, High Priest of the new and eternal covenant. And by your wondrous design, we're pleased to decree that his one priesthood should continue in the church. For Christ not only adorns with a royal priesthood the people he has made his own, but with a brother's kindness, he also chooses men to become sharers in his sacred ministry through the laying on of hands. They are to renew in his name the sacrifice of human redemption, to set before your children the paschal banquet, to lead your holy people in charity, to nourish them with your word, and strengthen them with the sacraments. As they give up their lives for you and for the salvation of their brothers and sisters, they strive to be conformed to the image of Christ himself and offer you a constant witness of faith and love. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks as in exaltation we acclaim.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
To you, therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant, Francis, our Pope, and me, your unworthy servant, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and apostolic faith.
Remember, Lord, your servant, and all gathered here whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you this sacrifice of praise, or they offer it for themselves and all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls and a hope of health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, the eternal God, living and true. In communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever-Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, and blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, and Jude, Linus, Clictus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmos, and Damian, and all of your saints. We ask that through their merits and prayers, to all things we may be defended by your protection and help.
Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family. Order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ, your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty, from the gifts that you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the Just, the sacrifice of Abraham our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing.
Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with the sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants, to those sinners, hope in your abundant mercy, graciously grant some share in fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord.
Through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord, you sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them and bestow them upon us.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. Thank you.
Let us pray. May the divine sacrifice we have offered and received, O Lord, give new life to your priests and to all your servants, that united to you in unfailing love, they may receive the grace of giving worthy service to your majesty. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in peace. Thanks be to God. Saint Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our safeguard against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O saints of the heavenly hosts, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.
Please join in our closing song, America the Beautiful, number 862, in the blue hymnal, number 862.